हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू वावाईएएस। वेलकम टू द डिस्कशन ऑन डेली एमसीक्यू। टुडे इज 15th of July 2021 एंड नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस फाइव करंट अफेयर बेस्ड एमसीक्यूज। तो चलिए शुरू करते हैं। फर्स्ट लेट अस डिस्कस द क्वेश्चन दैट वाज आस्क्ड यस्टरडे। कल का क्वेश्चन था, वेयर इज द न्यू सोलार थर्मल कॉम्पोनेंट्स टेस्टिंग फैसिलिटी लोकेटेड। सो रिसेंटली दिस वॉज एस्टैब्लिश्ड एंड दैट्स वे आई हैव आस्क्ड दिस क्वेश्चन। And some of you have given the correct answer. And yesterday it was Divya Vasisht who gave the correct answer. So if you see this new solar thermal components testing facility, it was established in Hyderabad, Telangana. Okay. So this new solar concentrated test thermal based test rig facility will help in the development of solar industry in India. So because this test facility will help in the development of new equipments that are needed for the development of solar technology. Okay, so this test facility, it will test the capability and performance of solar thermal components like the solar receiver tubes, solar heat transfer fluids and concentrating mirrors. Currently we are importing all of these components either from Europe or from China, and now with the development of this test facility we will be able to test all of the equipments in India and develop them indigenously only. Okay, so this will also help in the cutting down of cost of the solar technology. Okay, so this is all the information about this new concentrated solar thermal testing facility. Now let's move on. And guys, daily we are uploading five current affair based MCQs and their solutions in a PDF format. You can download it from our Telegram channel, and the Telegram channel details are there in the description. Now let's begin. The first question, consider the following statements with respect to Bheem UPI. Okay, first one, it is developed by the National Payments Corporation of India, NPCI, which allows real-time fund transfer. And second one, Bhutan is the only country outside India to have accepted the Bheem UPI at merchant locations. So here we have to choose the correct answer, A1 only, B2 only, C both 1 and 2, and D neither 1 nor 2. So if you see these two statements, the first one is right. So this Bheem UPI is developed by the National Payment Corporation of India, NPCI, which allows real-time fund transfer instantaneously. So the first one is right. But if you see the second statement, Bhutan is the only country outside India to have Bheem UPI acceptance. This is wrong, because apart from Bhutan, Singapore also accept Bheem UPI at merchant location, Singapore. Okay, so that's why the second statement is wrong. The first statement is right, and A, one only, is the correct answer. So recently Bhutan became the first country to adopt India's UPI standards for its quick response code, for its QR code. And with this, Bhutan became the second country after Singapore to have Bheem UPI acceptance at the merchant locations, right? So that means Bhutan is now accepting UPI as its QR code standard. So the Bheem, actually the full form of Bheem is the Bharat Interface for Money. It is India's digital payment application that works through UPI and developed by the NPCI, the National Payment Corporation of India, and this was launched in December 2016. The UPI is the Unified Payment Interface. UPI means Unified Payment Interface, and it is a real-time payment system. It is a real-time payment system, and it allows users to transfer money instantaneously across multiple bank accounts without revealing details of the bank account of the other party. So it is a very useful method, and currently most of the transactions are happening through UPI. Okay, now let's move on to the second question. The second question is, Karman line, sometimes referred in the media is, so recently this Karman line was in news. A, boundary between Earth's atmosphere and outer space. B, demilitarized zone to separate North Korea and South Korea. C, line separating India's areas of Jammu and Kashmir from Aksai Chin. And D, line that divides the daylight side and the dark night side of the Earth. So we have to choose the correct answer, and the correct answer is A, boundary between Earth's atmosphere and the outer space. So recently the British businessman Richard Branson, he has bet his rival Jeff Bezos, who is the founder of Amazon, to reach the edge of the space, giving space tourism an official kickstart. So you might have seen the media about this rich businessman who have visited the space. Okay, so that's why this was in news. So experts suggest that the actual boundary between Earth and the space, it lies somewhere between 18.5 miles, that is 30 kilometers above the Earth, to 1.6 million kilometers away. So this boundary is nothing but the Karman line. So this Karman line is based on the Hungarian-born aerospace pioneer Tudorel von Karman. Okay, so the main thing with this Karman line is that all the laws of physics, what we talk about, the drag, the buoyancy, everything, those are applicable only below this Karman line, only below this. But above the Karman line, all these laws of physics will not be applicable. So the buoyancy and everything, what the aircrafts face, aircrafts will experience in the atmosphere, will not be faced above this Karman line. So the aircrafts, generally they will be needed a propulsion system that do not rely on lift generated by Earth's atmosphere beyond this Karman line. Okay, so that is the thing with this Karman line, and this is all the information that we need to know about this Karman line. Okay, now let's move on to the next question, the third question. Consider the following statements with respect to Solar Energy Corporation of India Limited. First one, it is a CPSU, that is Central Public Sector Undertaking under the administrative control of Ministry of Environment and Forest. Second one, it is the only central public sector undertaking dedicated to the solar energy sector. So here we have to choose the correct answer. A, one only, B, two only, C, both one and two, and D, neither one nor two. If you see this statement carefully, the Solar Energy Corporation of India. So it is related to solar energy. So the first statement, if you see, it is given that it is a PSU which is under the administrative control of Ministry of Environment and Forest. Guys, so these days we are talking about this renewable energy, and solar is a main component of this renewable energy. And we have this ministry called the MNRE, the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy. So we have this New and Renewable Energy Ministry. So why will this Solar Energy Corporation go under the Ministry of Environment? The answer is no. So easily, the first statement will become wrong, but the second statement is right. It is the only central public sector undertaking dedicated to the solar energy sector. Okay, so here I have given the information. So recently, the NTPC Renewable Energy Limited has received a go-ahead from the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy to set up India's largest solar park. Okay, and this will be set up in Run-off Kutch in Gujarat. Okay, it will be a 4,750 megawatt renewable energy park in the Kavada district of Gujarat. Okay, and the Run-off Kutch. So this will be India's largest solar park to be built by largest power producer. And the scheme for development of solar parks and ultra mega solar power projects was rolled out in December 2014. And under this scheme, various solar power projects were set up. And if you see this Solar Energy Corporation of India, it is a central public sector undertaking under the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy, as I told already. And it is the only central public sector undertaking dedicated to the energy sector. Okay. So this is all the information that we need to know. And if someone asks you what is the main duty of this Solar Energy Corporation of India, so the main duty is to carry on business with regarding to generation, forecasting, purchasing, producing, manufacturing, importing, exporting, exchanging, selling and trading of power related to all the renewable energy. Okay, so this is all the information about this. Now let's move on to the next question. The fourth question, Periyar Tiger Reserve, sometimes seen in the news, is located in which of the following states? Periyar Tiger Reserve, A, Tamil Nadu, B, Kerala, C, Andhra Pradesh, and D, Goa. So Periyar Tiger Reserve is located in B, Kerala. So here is the location of Periyar Tiger Reserve. So this is the location here. Yeah, here it is located, Periyar Tiger Reserve, the Periyar National Park in Kerala. Okay, it is near to the border of Kerala and Tamil Nadu, right? So recently, there was an attempt in the Periyar Tiger Reserve to reintroduce an abandoned 9-month-old cub named Mangala after rearing it in captivity for 2 years. And this has brought the controversial concept of rewilding of abandoned and injured animals under the lens. So this cub has to be reintroduced into the wild, but its survival is the main question. Because normally these big cats, generally they will be very territorial. Okay, so this Periyar Tiger Reserve, it falls in the district of Idukki and Pathanamthitta in Kerala. So Idukki, if you see last year when during the rains, there was this dam in Idukki, and this dam is located between the borders of Kerala and Tamil Nadu, and it was a huge controversy. So the major reserves that pass through this reserve is the Mulayar and Periyar, and this Periyar Tiger Reserve has derived its name from this river Periyar. And it comprises of trees belonging to tropical evergreen, semi-evergreen, moist deciduous and the grasslands. And there are 6 tribal communities that live in this. They are the Manans, Palians, Malayarians, Malapandarans, Uralis and Ulladans. So these are the various tribal groups that live in this tiger reserve, this Periyar National Park, you can say. Okay, now let's look at the fifth question. Consider the following statements. First one, cabinet committees are extra constitutional in emergence. Second one, all the 8 cabinet committees are headed by the prime minister. So we have to choose the correct answer. A1 only, B2 only, C both 1 and 2, and D neither 1 nor 2. So cabinet committees, okay. So these cabinet committees are extra constitutional in emergence. They are not constitutional. So first statement is right. But if you see the second statement, all the 8 cabinet committees are headed by the prime minister. This is wrong, because only 6 cabinet committees are headed by the prime minister. The cabinet committee on parliamentary affairs and the cabinet committee on accommodation, both of them are headed by the home minister. So that's why the second statement is wrong and the first statement is right, and A1 only is the correct answer. So here I've given the details about the cabinet committees. So there are 8 cabinet committees: appointment committee, accommodation committee, economic affairs committee, parliamentary affairs committee, political affairs, security, investment and growth committee, and committee on employment and skill development. So all these are the 8 cabinet committees, and all are headed by the prime minister, except the cabinet committee on accommodation and cabinet committee on parliamentary affairs. And these cabinet committees are extra constitutional in emergence, and they are guided by the rules of business of the house of the parliament. Okay, so this is all the information about the cabinet committees, right? Now let's look at the question of the day. Question of the day is, what is Mission Karmayogi? So Mission Karmayogi was launched last year and it was in news. So this is very important for us from the prelims perspective. So tomorrow we are going to look at this Mission Karmayogi. So do give your answer in the comment box, and tomorrow we will discuss this question. And guys, these are our initiatives. Okay, we have launched Vision Prelims Test Series Summary, Vision Mains Test Series Summary, Vision PT 365 Summary, and Vision Monthly Magazine Summary as well. So if you have any questions, if you have any doubts, you can visit our Telegram channel where all the details are given, and you can also check the quality of these initiatives. Okay, so make the best use of these initiatives so that you can clear prelims with flying colors. Okay, so that's it guys for the day. I'll see you again tomorrow with 5 more MCQs. Till then, keep studying and stay tuned. Jai Hind.